Where's the spot?
When the buzz got out that KISS was finally going to reunite, that the impossible was going to happen, it spread like wildfire. Many of the magazines that wanted us on the cover, we refused. But Spin got it early on. They were ready to do four separate covers, something they had never done before. And just like us, they were ready to break ground. And together we did.
The issues came out, and they were by far the biggest sellers they'd ever had.
News was spreading quickly that the Alive Worldwide Tour was going to be a bigger success than anyone had even imagined.
KISS is back, the original four members in the original makeup.
Oh God, am I excited. I've been waiting 20-something years for this.
Bueno, salimos un instante de este enorme recinto.
Break out your face paint, get ready to rock.
Hundreds of fans will kiss and tell after their date tonight.
With the enormous reaction to the first month of the tour, the KISS buzz soared to new heights.
Forbes magazine came to us and wanted to put us on the cover. We thought that was a strange request, but why not? If we can help them look cool, so much the better.
One of the great things about KISS is that we don't live or die by the press, and it's much more important to us to go out on stage and be received by an audience that's ecstatic and meets us with open arms and legs. It's really something to look out there and see people who have waited for this day, sometimes 20 years, and what they think and their reaction is of the utmost importance. And what we see in the newspaper perhaps a day later is really of minor importance. Most of the time I just look and hope there's a great photo, because the photo is worth 1,000 words.
At the end of the day though, after all the hoopla and after all the covers of the magazines and so on, the most important thing for us is gauging our fans. When a fan walks up to you and says, you know, I don't like the second song as much as the fourth, I listen. When a critic has something to say, it means nothing. This guy's being paid for his job, and his opinion just really comes from nowhere. He's not a fan. He doesn't have any emotional vested interest in it. But when a fan talks, the heart speaks, we listen. The KISS Army started in Terre Haute, Indiana, the heartland of America, by a guy named Bill Starkey. It started around a radio station that wouldn't play our records, and Starkey, who called and basically threatened the guy and said, if you don't play KISS records, the KISS Army will surround you, somehow got back to us either through newspapers or letters about an existing KISS Army. And we thought the idea was so cool, why not name the fans the KISS Army? So the fan club was named that and so on. It started very naturally and kept growing.
They treat their fans with respect. They give the fans what they pay for, their money's worth.
They give everything to their fans that they have. They've been doing it for years.
Part of the magic of KISS is that the appeal is so widespread. There's something about KISS that affects everybody.
Well, they're all very talented, but I love Paul's ass in particular.
We have fans who were there from the beginning. Some of who now have their own children. And it's almost like a rite of passage to have the children show up and be a part of the concert that may have turned their parents' lives around. It's awesome to look out into an audience and see families, mothers, fathers, children, all part of this unique celebration that's KISS.
In the most sincere form of gratitude, all kinds of things get thrown up on stage. Sometimes bras, that's obvious. There have been babies held up. But the one that takes the cake is someone's leg. Up to that point, we thought we'd seen it all, but that one topped them all. If this is an army, this is clearly a volunteer army. Anybody who does something for KISS or about KISS is really doing it from their hearts, and that's the most important thing.
KISS is the biggest band of the 70s, 80s, and now 90s, and they're going to prove to the world that they're still the best. They changed rock and roll forever.
My only words are, space with Ace.
Do this for